May 17th, 2021, an extremely unusual storm event was marinating in a very unstable Texas atmosphere. During the day, Jupiter-like storm clouds brought an alien ambience to Earth. However, for me, the big show was after sunset.
Sweet.
Big ghost, holy moly.
Oh my gosh, this is the craziest sprites I've ever gotten. And there's a falling star.
Hello everyone, I wanted to share the most incredible sprite storm I've seen to date. Big red sprites, green ghosts, and other neato captures. Also, let's discuss what sprites look like to the naked eye. As many of you know, friend and collaborator Paul Smith and I discovered green ghosts in 2019. Green ghosts are faint, aurora-like glows that seem to accompany more powerful red sprites. Paul estimated that one in every 500 sprites in his observations ghost. On this night, I captured over 100 sprites, and six of them were accompanied by detectable green ghosts. Some were barely noticeable, but others were the brightest I've seen. Check out this double ghost. The most powerful lightning strikes are responsible for triggering sprites. Sometimes several of these big daddies connect to the ground in a very short time, causing several sprites to pop above the storm in succession.
Gosh, that was incredible.
We call these events dancing sprites.
Boom, ba-da-boom, dancing sprites all over the place.
Another super weird thingy that occurred on this evening is what has been dubbed a palm tree event. Notice how all the tendrils of these jellyfish streamers branch downward like roots. Now watch how this one differs. The roots branch upward. What the heck is that all about? So do sprites really look like this in person? Before ever capturing a sprite on camera, I saw one with my naked eye. I had already accumulated numerous sprite hunting failures, and finally, one dark moonless night, I was staring over a thunderstorm to see if anything was going on, and I saw a little splash of white light that was unmistakably a sprite. In a crazy madness, I tossed up my gear as fast as I could and caught my first sprites on camera, nice and out of focus.
How are you doing?
Brenda Brown also describes seeing sprites like this. It seems the photoreceptors in our eyes at night have poor sensitivity perceiving dim red light, so the little further away sprites seem white to us. However, the big closer sprites are clearly red in person. The cameras I use to capture sprites are highly sensitive to light, so the sprites turn out much more vibrant and detailed than what you would see. Here's a comparison of a captured big sprite and what I remember it looking like to the naked eye.
Wow, I just saw that one and it looked like it was a gigantic jet.
Just like with tornadoes and lightning storms, each sprite storm brings its own unique theme and fiery snowflake characteristics. To give you an idea of how special this night was, here's a time lapse of all the transient luminous events and weirdo things I captured that evening. See if you can see the ghosts.
Wow. Oh my goodness. What a storm. Recording the frogs and the coyotes. Listen. They just keep coming.
With the help of several scientists and other TLE fanatics, Paul Smith and I made a video explaining how sprites form and how we discover green ghosts. I'll hook you up with that link. Thanks for watching, everyone.
Until next time, friends, happy trails.